This is our professional development plan on multicultural literature by Michelle Huffman, Corinne Cicliano, and Jamie Williams.
The definition of multicultural literature is that literature represents any distinct cultural group through accurate portrayal and rich detail. Multicultural literature has often been used to show only positive images of minority cultures. However, in its most authentic form, it is an area of literature that focuses on the reality of various cultures.
We chose the topic of multicultural literature because it serves as a dual purpose in the lives of children. Books can make a difference in dispelling prejudice and building community, not with role models and literal recipes, not with noble messages about the human family, but with enthralling stories that make us imagine the lives of others. A good story lets you know people as individuals and all their particularity and conflict, and once you see someone as a person, flawed, complex, striving, then you've reached beyond stereotype. Stories, writing them, telling them, sharing them, transforming them, enrich us and connect us and help us know each other.
Criteria for selecting multicultural literature: choosing characters, choosing settings, choosing themes, choosing language, and choosing illustrations.
The criteria for choosing characters include having characters that should authentically reflect the distinct cultural experience of a specific cultural group. The names of characters should be culturally authentic, and their personalities should reflect attributes. Characterization should be true to life and balanced, representing both positive and negative behaviors and traits. Perpetuation of cultural stereotypes must be avoided, and gender roles within the culture should be portrayed authentically, reflecting the changing roles and status of women and men in cultures.
When choosing a setting, settings should be representative of a consistent and with historical or contemporary time, place, or situation of a particular culture. Factual information describing a historical setting must be accurate in detail. Contemporary settings must align with current situations of a cultural group.
When choosing themes, themes should be consistent with the values, beliefs, customs, traditions, and conflicts of the specific cultural group. Social issues and conflicts related to cultural groups should be treated honestly, accurately, and openly.
When choosing language, you should look for language that should reflect the distinctive vocabulary, style, and patterns of speech of the cultural group. Dialect should be natural and blend with plot and characterization while not being perceived as substandard language. And language should represent sensitivity to a people. Derogatory terms should be excluded unless essential to a conflict or used in historical context.
When choosing illustrations, physical characteristics of people of a diverse culture should replicate natural appearance and avoid stereotypes. Illustrations should reflect accurate cultural setting. Characters should be portrayed as unique individuals within a culture. Illustrations should be complement and enhance imagery of the story.
Additional selection criteria: stereotyping, loaded words, no distortion or omission of history, lifestyles, example, LGBT, authors and illustrators' background, or copyright date.
There are many benefits of using multicultural literature. One is it creates an understanding of cultural groups. Another is an increased respect among and between members of cultural groups, a self-understanding from the perspective of members of a cultural group, and a call for social action to assure the equality of cultural groups within our society and around the world.
The following is a resource list of multicultural children's books. For African American, I Love My Hair and The Music in Derek's Heart. When you're choosing African American books, you should choose experiences that are diverse and unique. Classroom Library reflects this diversity, as well as the blacks of living in places such as the Caribbean, Africa, and Great Britain. Reject books with offensive expression, negative attitudes, or stereotypes. You'll know them when you see them. Trust your instincts. Don't ignore these books because there are no children of color in your classroom. Books depicting African-American experiences are valuable for all children.
Some Native American books are Gift Horse by S.D. Nelson and Grandmother's Dreamcatcher by Becky Ray McCain. And keep in mind when selecting Native American books, make available books that reveal today's Native American cultures. Be prepared to talk about the ways in which Native American cultures have influenced world culture. Talk about values Native American cultures share, such as respect, sharing, and reverence for living things. Avoid books that suffer from what Joseph Brocker refers to as the Dances with Wolves syndrome, books in which all Indians are noble and all white people are bad. Any children's book that builds up one culture at the expense of another ultimately keeps racial tensions alive.
When choosing Asian American books, search for stories that exhibit values inherent in many Asian cultures, such as cooperation and a respect for family and tradition. Ensure that the events depicted are historically accurate. In a work of fiction, that the events described are plausible. Asian American children, as well as others in the class, should perceive the characters as competent problem solvers, responding in positive ways to the challenges they confront. While including stories whose settings are in the United States, it is also appropriate to include those set in other countries, thus providing students with a richer description of the cultural roots of Asian American students. And two examples are Baseball Saved Us and Yunmi and Halmoni's Trip.
Some Latino and Hispanic books would be Amelia's Road and In My Family, In Mi Familia. When choosing Latino American books, select books that show Hispanic women in contemporary roles, share biographies of Latinos so students understand Latinos' contributions to the U.S. and to the world, use picture books and novels as a way to inspire students to learn more about the history and the culture of Latino group depicted in the story. Look for stories that use Spanish words and phrases. They provide realism and show respect for the culture. Learn to pronounce the Spanish words correctly. Many books include pronunciation guides to help you.
Some Middle Eastern books are Salam, a Muslim American Boy's Story by Trisha Brown, and The Librarian of Basara, a True Story from Iraq by Jeanette Winters.
And some examples of LBGT books are Molly's Family by Nancy Garden, and Daddy, Papa, and Me by Leslie Newman.
Our references are A Celebration of Literature in Response and Multicultural Children's Literature, Creating and Applying an Evaluation Tool in Response to the Needs of Urban Educators.
Thank you.